Okay, we're going to the posterior portion of the lower leg, and we're going to talk about the gastrocnemius, this nice big calf muscle right here. We have our lateral head, we have our medial head, and what it does is it's flexion of the leg at the knee joint. So notice this knee joint right here, it's actually going to flex it, bring it from that 180 to that 90 degrees or less. So it's kind of like you're doing a butt kicker. You're going to bring the heel up to your butt right here at your knee, or the glute, I should say. Pardon me. Next, it's going to be responsible for plantar flexion. So notice how dorsiflexion was bringing your foot up to stop the door. Well, plantar flexion is actually pushing to the ground. So I think you're pushing your foot to the ground. Dorsiflexion is you're stopping the door with your foot. So this one is actually responsible for plantar flexion. So you're pushing that foot, trying to go on your tippy toes. Next, we're going to talk about the soleus. And the soleus, we know, is going to be this muscle that runs right along here. It's under your calf muscle, right? That big part of the gastrocnemius. And the soleus is responsible. It's an additional supporter of the plantar flexion. So it's going to help you push your toes down into the ground. And lastly, we're going to go over our flexor hallucis longus. So flexor, you know it's going to be on the posterior side. And so I'm going to turn you... I want you to see the lateral side of your leg so we can kind of get some orientation here, right? We have this fibularis longus, this peroneus muscle is kind of on the anterior lateral side, we'll say. So if the flexor hallucis longus, that flexor of the big toe, it's going to bring the curl of the big toe. It's not really superficial. It's actually deep. So it's right here. So if you notice on the side, I had to remove the calf muscles. It's not here in the front. It's really deep. So this is going to be the flexor of the big toe, hallux, the flexor hallucis longus.